Today, I'm going to be talking a bit about Terraform and how it can integrate with Power Platform and how you can use Terraform to manage your Power Platform estate. I'm going to be covering concepts in kind of high level. So if anyone wants any more detail, feel free to reach out to me on LinkedIn if they want to go over anything specific. So before we get into the main topic, just a little bit about myself. So, by nature, I'm currently working as a DevOps engineer, and my work right now involves kind of solutions across Power Platform and Azure. My background is as an infrastructure engineer. So, before I stumbled across Power Platform, I was working with VMware, vCenter servers, Windows servers, Cisco networking equipment, all that good stuff. And in terms of Power Platform, I've worked across Canvas apps, model-driven apps, Power Automate, and a bit of governance and ELM and DLP policies, that kind of thing. Now, before we get into how Power Platform can integrate with Terraform, I wanted to cover a bit about what is Terraform and what are some of the benefits of using it. So Terraform is infrastructure as code. So you declare your infrastructure as code, and then Terraform goes and deploys it rather than clicking around a GUI. Typically, it's used to deploy cloud resources across various platforms, so Azure, AWS, GCP, that sort of thing. And it's a declarative language, so you essentially declare in your Terraform configuration files exactly what you want to deploy. You don't need to tell it how to deploy it. You just tell it what's to be deployed, and it will go and deploy it for you. Now, with that being said, why might you use Terraform? What are some of the benefits? So, firstly, it's open source, so it works across various platforms. So, as I said, you can use it to deploy to Azure, to AWS, to GCP, to Power Platform, as I'm going to show you in a minute. And also, you can use it to deploy to on-premise VMware infrastructure as well, and a whole host of other platforms, so the sky really is the limit with that one. The idea of Terraform and kind of writing your infrastructure as code is you can kind of write it once and deploy it repeatedly. So it's reusable in nature, which is always good. And not only can Terraform deploy your infrastructure, but it's got a concept called state management where it knows about what it's deployed. So even after you've deployed some infrastructure, if you want to update that infrastructure, you can do that via Terraform, and it will manage your infrastructure through the entire life cycle. Another good thing about using infrastructure as code and Terraform in particular is you're deploying resources in a consistent manner. So if you think about deploying, you know, three virtual machines in Azure, you know, if you've got three cloud engineers, each one of them might deploy a VM in slightly different fashion. They might use slightly different naming convention, they might use slightly different tags. One person might forget to check a box for some configuration element. Whereas if you've got all of that defined in Terraform configuration files, you're just running that Terraform and it's deploying those VMs exactly as you've specified. So it removes the element of human error. As I mentioned before, Terraform will manage your resources once it's deployed them. So a benefit of that is that you can also easily destroy your infrastructure. Now, I know that sounds a bit scary, but it's also good for like ephemeral infrastructure. So one of the things I'm thinking about just now is a concept of like ephemeral Power Platform environments with like pre-dev. So if Power Platform devs want to, you know, do some pre-dev work, that don't necessarily want to interfere with the official dev build, they just want to test out some beta things, we can use Terraform to spin up some Power Platform environments, and then once they're done, you can take them back down again with Terraform without having to go into each individual environment and delete them from the GUI. And it can also be automated using Azure DevOps or GitHub Actions. Another really good thing about Terraform, especially for me who is not a traditional software developer, is that the programming language is very human readable. Now, we'll see that when I come to demonstrate some of the Terraform code, is that it's very easy to look at Terraform blocks and know exactly what it should be deploying with what parameters. And lastly, using Terraform and deploying in this manner, you're really taking away that unnecessary click ops of having to click around the GUI. If you think about something like deploying a Power Platform environment, you know, if you're deploying, you know, two or three of them, you're having to click around the GUI two and three times. Again, it takes longer and you're also introducing human error, whereas something like Terraform takes that away completely. Now, with that being said, we will jump into a demonstration where I'm going to demonstrate how we can deploy multiple Power Platform environments with Terraform configuration files. So if I drag my Chrome window across here, you'll see I'm in my Azure DevOps environment. I've got a pipeline which is going to create me some Power Platform environments using Terraform. So if I run this, and I'll talk a bit about the code and exactly what it's doing. So let's run that just now. So first thing the pipeline does is it runs Terraform initialize, and that's, as you may have guessed, it's initializing Terraform. So that's your first step in the Terraform workflow, is to initialize your Terraform installation file on the host agent machine. And what that's doing is it's checking the version of Terraform, it's downloading the providers that you've specified, and it's also making sure that your version of your provider that you're using matches and is compatible with the version of the Terraform installation that you've got running on the host machine. Now, once it's finished the initialization, we'll see here Terraform has been successfully initialized. It's then going to go on to the apply stage. Now, before it runs Terraform, or during the Terraform apply...
Hey Brian, sorry to interrupt. Is there any way you could zoom in a little bit just so the fonts are a little bit clearer?
Yep. Let me do that on the browser.
Awesome. Thank you. Perfect.
So, while it runs, as part of Terraform apply, it's going to run what's called a Terraform plan step. And what that does is... Terraform plan essentially tells you what Terraform is going to do without actually doing it. So if you're making changes to your infrastructure and you want to just sense check what you're doing is actually going to do what you intended to do, then you run Terraform plan as a separate step, and that'll tell you exactly what's going to be done before you apply it. And if we look here, we should see, yep, so you can see there it's run Terraform plan, it's telling us what it's going to do. So down here it's telling us it's going to add two resources, which is my two Power Platform environments. And this is then being created here. And we can see the apply is complete, successfully added two resources, and it's even given us some outputs with the environment IDs as well. Now if I switch over to my Power Platform admin center, and I refresh the browser, we should see we've got two extra environments here, and that was these ones that were deployed using Terraform. Now, if I bring in my VS Code, and David, just let me know if you want me to zoom in any more on this, or if that's readable.
No, that's good. Yeah, that's good. Thank you.
We'll take a look at the code that we used to deploy those environments. So as I was saying before, Terraform is very human readable. So from this block, we can see we're deploying a resource. The resource we're deploying is a Power Platform environment. I've given the resource block a name, and this is where we start filling in our parameters for that environment. So we're giving it a display name, we're giving it a description, we're specifying the location, we're setting the environment type as developer, and we're giving it an owner ID and some Dataverse parameters there as well around language, codes, and currency. Now, this is actually a reusable module. So what I've done is I've got the module files here, and I'm calling that module from my root module here. So you'll see here, this is me in my root module, and I'm going out and I'm calling that Terraform module that I just showed you. And what we're actually doing is we're defining multiple display names and multiple descriptions for each environment. So in my locals file here, I'm saying that I want I've got an array with two objects. So this is saying that I want two environments, one with the name of dev env1, the other one with dev env2, and specifying a description for each. And then when I call my module, I'm just telling it that I want an environment for each of those locals. And that's how it's creating the two environments that you saw in the admin center. Now, in this example, this is a fairly simple example. I'm creating two identical environments that are both developer type and that, you know, I've got all the same settings. But you could, in your local cell, you could define different settings for each environment. So I could deploy, you know, a full set of dev, UAT, and production environments. I could have one of them being a developer type, I could have one being a sandbox type, and I could have one being a production type, all just defined within Terraform without having to click around the GUI multiple times. So that's just a quick snapshot, really, of how simple it can be to deploy multiple Terraform environments without having to really go around the GUI and click multiple times. Now, if I go back to the presentation, let me just get it up here. And now, deploying environments is just one use of Terraform within Power Platform. And also worth noting that you can deploy both standard and managed environments with Terraform. So the example I showed you was using standard, but there's also a separate resource for managed environments as well. You can also deploy your DLP policies. So you can create your environments. You can then, within the same Terraform configuration, you can define your DLP policies so that when you're creating environments, they're getting, the environments are being created and they're also getting the DLP policies applied as well. And further to that, you can also create and manage your connections and your tenant and environment settings within Terraform. So what you can do is, within a single set of Terraform configuration files, you can deploy the environment, the DLP policy, any connections, any settings, and then that way, as soon as you run Terraform apply against those configuration files, the environment is fully ready for the developer to utilize and begin development. You can also manage your Power Platform solutions within Terraform. Now, typically this would be done using something like PAC CLI or Power Platform build tools for a fully fledged ALM process. But if you wanted to, you know, make complete use of Terraform within Power Platform, you can utilize it to move solutions between environments as well. And since David had said I've got a bit more time, I'm going to quickly show you some of the code for deploying a DLP policy using Terraform. So similar pattern to the environment that you saw, we've got a resource block. We're telling it we want to deploy a Power Platform data loss prevention policy. We're giving the resource block a name. And then we've then got variables defined for the display name, the environment type, and what environments we want that policy to apply to. And then what's quite useful within this block is, if you imagine, if you think about when you're creating DLP policies using the GUI, you have to go in and you have to mark connectors manually as business or non-business or blocked. Well, when you do it all through Terraform, you can just define your business connectors in a variable, and then you can dynamically generate your non-business connectors and your blocked connectors. So what this is doing here is, we've got our business connectors defined in a variable within our variables, within our variables file here. So we're defining our business connectors in here. And then, so these are our business connectors here. These are the values for that variable. And then what we're doing is we're dynamically generating our non-business connectors and our blocks connectors. So it's saying that if the connector is not blockable, so if unblockable equals true, and it's not in the business connectors list, then it goes into non-business connectors. And similarly, if unblockable equals false and it's not in the business connectors, then it gets blocked. And again, we can also define patterns for custom connectors. So again, this lets you create really complex, customized DLP policies without having to go in and manually mark connectors as blocked, as business, as non-business. You define it all within your Terraform configuration files, and you can even dynamically generate your connector list as well. And if we go back to the presentation before I finish up, I just wanted to point you in the direction of the Terraform registry. So this is documentation for the Power Platform provider. So this will tell you exactly basically everything you can manage and deploy within Power Platform using Terraform. So any resource within Power Platform that you want to deploy using Terraform, you'll get all of the documentation for it on this link here. And with that, thank you for listening.